Why were the people happy to listen to Jesus? Why is everyone welcome to share moments with Jesus? Why did the scribes react in the way that they did? All these questions and more answered during today's episode of Daily Reflections. Once again, a large crowd is gathered to see and hear Jesus. In the year 70s, the time when Mark wrote the Gospel, in communities there was a conflict between Christians who had been converted from paganism and those from Judaism. Those from Judaism found it very difficult to enter into the house of converted pagans and to sit with them around the same table. In describing how Jesus faces this conflict, Mark orients the community to solve the problem. The Gospel emphasizes the new style of teaching of Jesus. Jesus taught, and the people were very happy to listen to him. Jesus goes out again to go near the sea. People arrive, and he begins to teach them. He transmits the word of God. In Mark's Gospel, the beginning of the activity of Jesus is characterized by much teaching and much acceptance on the part of the people in spite of the conflicts with religious authority. What did Jesus teach? Jesus proclaimed the good news of God. He spoke about God, but he spoke in a new way that was different. He spoke starting from his experience, of the experience which he himself had of God and of life. Jesus lived in God, and surely he had touched the heart of the people who liked to listen to him. God, instead of being a severe Jew who threatens from afar, at a distance with punishment and hell, become once again a friendly presence and the good news for the people. The Gospel also emphasizes the fact that everyone is welcome. Jesus calls a sinner to be a disciple and invites him to eat in his house. Jesus calls Levi a tax collector, and he immediately leaves everything and follows Jesus. He begins to be part of a group of the disciples. It is Jesus who invites all to eat in his house, sinners and tax collectors, together with the disciples. Levi, as a tax collector in a busy trading center, working for the detested Roman authorities, would have been ostracized by his fellow Jews. We marvel at the compelling power of Jesus' call and the instant positive response of Levi, who abandons everything to follow him. Levi invites all his disreputable friends to a big party at his house. We might well suspect the sources of his wealth. Jesus had no hesitation in joining in their table fellowship. He defends his positive outreach to sinners against the self-righteous criticism of the Pharisees. And then we see the reaction of the scribes. Jesus had come not for the just, but for the sinners. This gesture or act of Jesus causes the religious authority to get very angry. It was forbidden to sit at table with tax collectors and sinners, because to sit at table with someone meant that he was considered a brother. Instead of speaking directly with Jesus, the scribes and the Pharisees speak with the disciples. How is it that he eats and drinks together with tax collectors and sinners? It is the conscience of Jesus' mission which helps Jesus to find the response and to indicate the way for the proclamation of the good news of God. This whole story leads up to the arresting statement with which today's Gospel ends. Jesus has come not to call the righteous but sinners. Far from being a situation to be avoided, the company of sinners is precisely what Jesus needs to seek out. They are the most in need of his healing. This teaching applies today to the church, to our parishes, workplaces, and homes. Here are some points for our personal reflection. Jesus calls a sinner, a tax collector, a person hated by the people, to be his disciple. Which is the message for us in this act of Jesus? Are there laws and customs in our neighborhood which prevent sinners to have access to Jesus? What can we do to change these laws and these customs? How inclusive is our attitude to others? These points can be of great help to reflect on today's Gospel.
And if you like our reflection, do share the good news of our Lord. Have a good day, and may God bless you all. Amen.